Rachel Holt for NESN.com. Thanks for joining our fantasy football chat. I'm joined by John Halpin of Fox Sports. John, thanks for being here.
Anytime. Happy to be here.
All right, we're on to week 7. It's hard to believe, and it's the halfway point for many people in their fantasy football leagues, depending on when the playoffs are. So that's kind of crazy. But let's talk about the week that we just had in week 6. And first, let's start with the stars of this week. There were some guys that absolutely killed it. We're talking about Odell Beckham Jr. finally had his breakout week that we were all looking for. Then we had Rob Gronkowski getting in the mix of things in New England over there. There were some guys like David Johnson, Drew Brees, Ezekiel Elliott, the names that we all come to think that they're going to have a great week and just anticipate it. To you, who had the most impressive performance?
Well, one of those names you mentioned were all great, and for some of them it was about time. Some of them it was more of the same, like David Johnson. He's fantastic. Jay Ajayi on the Dolphins, running back, was just fantastic, 204 yards. And the funny part about that was, on Sunday morning, the Dolphins sort of announced that Arian Foster was going to be active. All week long, people were waiting for him to come back. They announced he was going to be active, and we all sort of went, oh, okay, great. So maybe we can play Foster today. So nobody started Ajayi, at least not nobody I can think of. He went out there and got over 200 yards. I think moving forward, look, Foster's brittle enough at this point that after the way Ajayi has played, and that's two games like that in the past few weeks, I don't think Foster's getting that job back unless something happens to Ajayi. If you can still get Ajayi in your league, he's available in 57% of leagues at foxsports.com. You really need to go grab him because it looks like he has a job.
Well, I can tell you I have him in two leagues, and I didn't start him in either one of them, so I was kicking myself. But hey, if there's a guy like Jay Ajayi and you can pick him up, it's a fantasy football dream at this point in the season. So in terms of some other guys like that, are there any other people that we can target on the waiver wire?
One guy who's really interesting to me right now is Colin Kaepernick. Look, week 7 coming, and you have Cam Newton's off, Dak Prescott's off, some people have been using him, Ben Roethlisberger's hurt and isn't going to play. So if you need a quarterback, Colin Kaepernick started against the Bills, and he's going to get another start this week at home against the Buccaneers, which is not the toughest opponent. Colin Kaepernick did not have a good real football day. But for fantasy purposes, he threw for a touchdown, he ran for 66 yards, and he wound up at foxsports.com, he was the 16th best fantasy quarterback. That's not great, but if you need someone off the wire, he might be able to help. And I think those numbers, that seems like it's probably a floor. I mean, maybe he runs for 50 yards instead of 66, but 180-some yards and a touchdown through the air, you got to figure he won't do worse, most likely. The Bucs are an easier opponent at home than the Bills were on the road. I think if you're looking for a quarterback for this week, Kaepernick's a pretty solid option.
Case Keenum also had a great week 6. Is he one of the guys where you can see the momentum continue to build?
No, I'm not a Case Keenum guy. The Giants' defense is kind of okay. They're not as bad as they were last year. They're probably not as good as I thought they'd be. I thought they were going to improve more, but that's still a pretty run-centric offense, and I think they'll probably try to do the same against the Giants on Sunday morning in London. I don't really like Case Keenum moving forward. I wouldn't own him in any leagues.
Aaron Rodgers was one of the guys that had a big dud of a week in week 6. All of his owners were a little frustrated, clearly. In terms of moving forward with Aaron Rodgers, do you have any concerns about that?
Yes. It's not like you're going to cut him, but we need to manage our expectations at this point. It's gone on too long for this to be just he'll be fine and he'll figure it out and he'll improve. I actually read a good thread on Twitter this morning from, I think it was Doug Farrar from Bleacher Report, just talking about how, you know, the line's playing well, but the receivers aren't getting any separation. And he's just not finding open receivers and he's seems to be getting frustrated with it. Seems like a good analysis. Rodgers is fine, but he's not going to be that top 5 quarterback in most weeks, or looks like he's not going to be that guy that you hoped you were getting when you drafted him.
Okay, at this point, going off the waiver wire, it's hard to find those JHIs in the mix because we pretty much already know who's performing and who isn't at this point. So as far as trade value, is there any guy that you would want to target who you see his value going up and up over the coming weeks?
All right, I'm stubborn, but I would still target Todd Gurley. It keeps looking like he's going to have that big day, and the Lions would have been a great place to have it, and he just hasn't. However, he's the type of guy who he's going to break those big runs sometimes. Now, he won't do it every week. If you look at last year, there were up and down games. He had huge games, and then he had some games where he was 25 for 75. And sometimes you live through those. But the big weeks are going to win you fantasy games. And I think you can get Todd Gurley for a somewhat discounted price right now. Not super cheap, but I think you'd probably be, if you traded for Todd Gurley, you'd probably not pay as much as I feel he's worth.
Okay, and obviously to trade for someone, you have to get rid of someone. And one of the guys that kind of sticks out to me as being a good trade option at this point is Julian Edelman. He's a guy that a lot of people bought into, and he really hasn't been performing. Is he one of those guys that you want to try to trade at a pretty good value and get off your team? Or do you think he might start to be producing here in New England?
Two things to that. First, I do think he might produce more because Brady has shown in the past that he likes to throw to him. And after 2 weeks, I don't know. I don't think we're judging Edelman on 6 weeks right now. I think we're judging him on two, and two is a little early for me. As far as trade value, unfortunately, his production has been low to the point where I don't know what you could get. So if I had Edelman, I'd probably hold and hope for the best. This week coming up against the Steelers, actually, their pass defense is not that great. I think he's startable.
Is there any guy like Aaron Rodgers, who we already mentioned, you might think we can possibly trade away? I know you said you would want to keep him, but any guy like that where you don't really see him doing too much the rest of the season?
I wonder if we're at the point with DeAndre Hopkins where, look, a guy like that is kind of like Edelman. You're selling low, but there are people out there who would still think that DeAndre Hopkins is going to turn things around and be the guy he was last year. I'm at the point where I'm not willing to say that. It's funny. I thought when they signed Brock Osweiler that, well, he didn't have to be really good. He just had to be as good as Brian Hoyer or better for Hopkins to be good. And I didn't think that was a big leap. Turns out that it might have been because Brock Osweiler until the second half on Sunday has been terrible. I think that if you sell DeAndre Hopkins now, I just don't know that the turnaround's there. I'm not seeing a lot of reason for it.
Big Ben's injury, how does it affect the Steelers there and the fantasy football points that you're getting from them?
Well, it means Le'Veon Bell's going to get the ball a billion times. That's one. I know some people have been noting this week that when Ben was out last year, Antonio Brown's production dropped. And that's true. But it dropped more with Michael Vick than it did with Landry Jones. Landry Jones had one full game, and Brown was 6 for 124. So I wouldn't think that the sky has fallen on Antonio Brown. I wouldn't be happy about the injury, certainly, but he's still startable, and there's still reason to think he can be productive.
Okay, and Odell Beckham Jr., we already mentioned him as having a great week six. Is he one of the guys that you think is just going to continue to rise and continue to have great weeks moving forward?
I think he's probably the guy you thought he was. He's going to be a top five fantasy receiver. He's going to have games like he had Sunday, and maybe he'll have a few off games, but you know, they're trying to feed him the ball, and when they do, he's one of those receivers, kind of like Antonio Brown, Julio Jones, who's almost uncoverable, not quite, but pretty close. So he's going to get his no matter how much teams focus on him.
Looking ahead for the matchups of Week 7, are there any teams that you're targeting right now that, you know, it looks like they're going up against a tough defense?
Let's see. I think the teams going up, I mean, the Browns are always going to, you know, it's funny, the Browns have been competitive. Every week you want to bet against them, but they've been competitive. They're going up against the Bengals, which is not the easiest thing. Looking at some other teams going on here, I mean, I think that the Steelers coming in against the Patriots, look, you're going to start Bell and Brown if you have them, but those secondary guys like Coates or maybe one of the tight ends, I don't know how much success they're going to have against the Pats. Also, the Texans play at Denver, and basically we're at the point where I guess I'd start Lamar Miller just because I doubt I'd have two running backs that are better. But for the most part, you just want to avoid any questionable fantasy options when they play against the Broncos.
Okay, any final nuggets of advice going into week 7 here? As you already mentioned, we have two teams on a bye, and there's some decisions that we have to make with injuries and that kind of thing. Any other words of wisdom?
I think my only other one, it's someone I mentioned earlier. All year, you look at the Browns, and they're 0-6. And your gut says, I just need to stay away from these guys. But you know what? They have been competitive, and they have been scoring points and getting yards. Hugh Jackson's a pretty good coach. They're offensive skill players. Look, they'll probably lose the game again playing on the road in Cincinnati. But their fantasy guys, Crowell, Duke Johnson, Terrell Pryor, if he's healthy, he's struggling with a hamstring injury. Those are guys that you still want to play. Don't let the Browns record fool you into thinking their fantasy guys aren't very good.
Okay, and my last question for you, John, is where can we find more from you?
You can always find my work at foxsports.com/fantasy and catch me on Twitter with any questions at jhalpin37.
All right. Thanks so much. We appreciate your insight. We look forward to talking to you in the coming weeks.